The driving landscape in Gauteng is likely to change, so are travel trends. This as motorists opt for back routes and others for trains, buses and taxis to avoid e-tolling.
I think initially there will be a switch to some of these modes. It depends how well they are in meeting the requirements of the commuter itself, you know, from origin to destination within reasonable time, cost and so on. I think Gautrain may benefit more than maybe other modes of transport, the taxi industry and the bus industry in certain respects.
The city of Johannesburg has declined to comment on the impact of e-tolls on other public transport modes in the city. Gautrain's management sees it as a positive development. They anticipate an increase in passenger numbers. About 35,000 passengers use the Gautrain daily between Pretoria, Sandton and OR Tambo International Airport.
We've tried to model it, but it's very difficult. The tolls would have been 1,100 rand with the negotiations with the government. The toll fees have now been kept at 550 rand a month. So we can't say, but we think 10 to 15% shift immediately from car users to train.
The rollout of the Gautrain link to Johannesburg in the next 2 months will also get more people to use the Gautrain. Plans are afoot to align Gautrain buses, which often run empty, with other bus services in Gauteng and Tshwane. John Motlogelwa, SABC News, Johannesburg.